Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Persona 5. I'm your host, The Musical Gamer, and I was checking things earlier. Apparently, we can feed our plant again, so we shall. We have one more garden energy, cheap plant nutrient, and I can finally show this off. I did this once before, because I didn't know what would happen. These are cheap, but it's far better than giving it nothing. And hey, we got a pip. Pip of kindness.
All right.
Which is great, and is totally free to do, so... Whenever you have the chance, feeding your plant is a great way to get, like, free stats. At least from as far as I can tell. Okay, so I think we have to go to bed, right? We can't, It's that old guy. Didn't think he would actually be famous. Yeah, we should rest up for tomorrow. That's what I figured. We have to go to bed. Because we're going to the exhibition! Ichi Ryusai Madarame. An infinite font of ideas, huh? I read the blurb on the ticket, but it seems that this Madarame is actually an amazing artist. Oh. Some of his pieces might be worth looking at after all. Well, let's go to bed. I will be the judge of that game! Me and my keen artistic sense. Meanwhile, our Phantom Thieves thing just keeps dropping further and further. Actually, wait, no, hold on. I think it went up. It's like hovering around like 5.86%. Yeah, probably some stunt. What's this line for? The exhibition must be opening today. It's really packed. I want it, but it's so expensive. Take out a loan. What, to go see an exhibition? What the hell? Why would you need to take out a loan to get a ticket for something? That's like, if you're in that piss poor financial situation that you have to do something like that, don't do it.
So crowded.
It'll be a pain in the ass if someone sees you, so don't stick your head out too much, all right?
Yeah, it's a good point. I don't think they're gonna appreciate a cat in the exhibit. Yeah,
you
go
came.
Oh, hey, Yusuke? How you doing?
Yeah.
You really came.
He just looks at Ryuchi, and he's like, you really came? God damn it.
What'd you expect when you left us those tickets?
Make sure that you don't get in the way of the other visitors.
Oh, jeez, fine. I was about to say, every time I see Yusuke...
Come now. I'll show you around. I'd like to speak more about the picture I'd like to draw, too.
Every time I see Yusuke, I see his name, I think of Yusuke Urameshi from Yu Yu Hakusho. I don't know why, just the name Yusuke just has left that with me on my psyche.
Well, see you guys later.
All right, good luck, Anne. Try not to wind up in the same
Lady Anne
shape
be
as
right?
Kamoshida.
What if he drags her behind some painting and tries something funny?
That was my first thought, too.
I told you not to come out! Are we really gonna appreciate the fine arts? Can't we just go home?
Oh, Ryuji, you barbarian. Well, yeah, that's true. While we're here, we should try to learn something about Madarame.
I guess we should do a quick pass through it once. Which way are we supposed to start?
Wherever, I guess. Oh, it's him.
It's that old man from the other day.
We continue to be truly surprised by your imagination. You have such expansive styles. It's hard to believe that it all stems from one person. Where in the world does all your inspiration come from?
Well, it is rather difficult to put into words. They naturally well up from within my heart, like bubbles rising one after another in the spring.
Naturally, you say?
God, you're a flowery fuck, aren't you?
What's important is to distance oneself from worldly desires, such as money and fame.
Okay, anybody who says that is clearly a villain.
My atelier is a modest shack, but it is more than enough to pursue true beauty.
A shack.
I see. So the act of emptying one's mind gives rise to inner beauty. Still, to think we could hear the word shack coming from the great artist Madarame.
You would understand if you saw it.
I beg to differ. I need to see this shack of yours.
Wasn't the word shack something?
Madarame-san is actually here?
Oh, no.
Over there!
Oh, no.
I'm so glad I came on opening day.
Or are you now? Oh, jeez!
Kay, stop pushing!
This exhibit became a regular old mosh pit in no time at all. Goddamn.
There's way too many people.
I'm getting crushed.
Anyways, we gotta head for the exit. Don't die on us, all right?
You don't die. Morgana, no!
I didn't know there were so many types of Japanese art.
Usually, one concentrates on their own style. However, Sensei creates all this by himself. He's special.
There or a crook. Are, Yusuke.
He could be a crook, and you just don't see it.
Sensei.
Ah, the girl from yesterday. Are you enjoying the exhibit?
I don't know how to put it into words, but it's really amazing.
You're sensing something from the artwork. That alone is enough to give us artists satisfaction. I hope this becomes a wonderful piece, Yusuke. Well then, if you'll excuse me.
You'd imagine artists would be difficult to approach, but he seems really friendly.
Indeed.
I don't know about that. I'm getting warning bells.
Oh, this is it! The painting I wanted to see in person.
And warning bells are firing off in my brain right now. And, I don't know, probably for good reason.
This one?
I guess it's the painter's anger? I'm not sure, but I sense this strong frustration from it. To think such a cheerful and gentlemanly person could make such a piece. Something wrong?
Don't mind me. There are better pieces than this one. Come now. This way.
What was that hesitation?
Hey!
What's going on? Do you actually know what's going on and you're just not admitting it? Is this like another, like, school administration Kamoshida thing?
Ah, that old lady totally elbowed me. Thanks to that, I remember now.
What? Wait, what about An? Where are we getting this from?
Let's not worry about it for now.
Oh, wait, what about An? Okay, as in she's not here to partake in Ryuji's moment of clarity and wisdom, which is probably never happening again.
Here, look at this.
Alright, what's up?
Why'd you leave without me?
Oh, about that. Kinda got,
you got it all
shoved
wrong.
Out.
We got dragged into this huge crowd, and anyways, you gotta look at this too. This post might be about Madarame.
Oh, really? What did you find?
What's it say?
A master of the Japanese arts is plagiarizing his pupil's work. Only his public face is shown on TV.
Plagiarizing?
I had a feeling.
I didn't think much of it when I first saw it, but hearing Shaq and Madarame triggered it.
How so?
His treatment of the pupils who live with him is awful. He teaches nothing and bosses them around. He treats them inhumanely, as if disciplining a dog.
Abuse on top of plagiarism, huh?
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
If this is real, it'll be a huge scandal.
Don't look too happy about it, Ryuji. If that's true, that means Yusuke is being abused like that. And he's probably too afraid to speak up.
I wonder if Kitagawa-kun posted this. I mean, he is a pupil of his.
Who knows? It's anonymous and all.
In that case, it's possible the Madarame we heard about in Mementos is referring to the same one.
A man like that doing such a thing? I wonder if we can ask that shadow from earlier about this. Oh,
the shadow.
Actually, we just need to talk to him in reality.
Oh, yeah. The person we actually saved. That, public employee? Civil servant?
How are we gonna go about that? Are we gonna explain it all, starting with Mementos?
That's also a fair point.
Besides, if we make a move out in the open, there's the possibility that Madarame will find out.
Oh, yeah, right.
So does that mean we can find out in Mementos again?
Hey, what do you think about Madarame? Doesn't he seem suspicious?
Who, me? He does. Something about him just seems sketchy. I don't know. Just, he kind of does to me.
I know, right? This all fits way too well to just be a coincidence.
Yeah, I agree.
If this post is legit, Ain't this the kind of target we've been waiting for?
Well, yeah, but is it really true?
By the way, what did you do about the whole modeling thing?
Oh, yeah.
Tagawa-kun gave me his contact info and the address to his sensei's atelier.
He said he lives there, right? Perfect timing.
I see what you're getting at. Time to do a little espionage.
Let's try going tomorrow. We're off to Madarame's house right after school.
Huh? You want me to model tomorrow? This is too sudden.
What? We're just gonna go talk to Kitagawa.
Oh, that's what you meant.
Oh my god, them saying his name like that is making me cringe. Oh, god. Kitagawa. Jesus. I really want to know what the hell they were thinking. It's such a minor nitpick, I guess, but it really kind of... It breaks me out of the immersion at the very least, and... I don't know, people who know more about, like, I guess Japanese pronunciation and diction and stuff like that, it'd probably do the same to them. For the common person, something like, you know, Takamaki, Kitagawa, it probably isn't going to bother them that much. But for someone with me, it's like, it's like this cacophonous sound to my ears. It's weird. I don't know. I don't like it. If there's anything I have to complain about the game so far, it's that. Direction they went with the voice acting for names. That is something I do not like about this. Yeah, it might be something we needed. So we just gotta go to bed yet again, right? No time to do anything else. Nope. Not at all. Yep, let's just call it a day and go to sleep. Who cares about your stats? Who cares about your social links? Who cares about anything but the nice, warm embrace of my fucking mattress? I'm not bitter. Who's bitter? Not me. Ha-ha! Kill me now.
Oh, yes.
Oh yeah, the great artist Madarame is holding an exhibition in Shibuya right now, isn't he? I've gone to see his works a number of times. Goodness, are they magnificent. The moment I saw them, I knew he was something else. By the way, you seem far removed from the arts, Gamer-kun. What? So you're gonna ask me a question, aren't you? Do you know who created the piece which sold for the highest price back in the 20th century? The 20th century? Madarame, no, I don't think so. Picasso or Van Gogh? Now hold on. I think I remember Picasso was like, what, an impressionist? So I don't think his pieces would have sold because, God, I know it's like a freaking Picasso painting. It's like just a bunch of mixed up jigsaw pieces, puzzle pieces. So I don't know. That kind of makes me feel like it wouldn't be him. I'm gonna guess Van Gogh. I would normally look this up, but. Oh, shit, I was right. Haha, nice. That piece was purchased for the equivalent of 18 billion yen. Holy crap. What is that, like? Like $180 million or something? However, since the turn of the 21st century, a new record has been set practically every year. He's kind of smart. Yeah, thanks.
Nice.
I boosted my knowledge. Screw you people. I get no respect. No respect at all in this joint. People put a serious amount of passion and money into art. If I had that kind of money, I wouldn't mind having a painting or two myself. Ha ha.
Hey, hey.
You pompous dick. Seems like art can make you buy it, or it seems like art can make you a tiny sum. Let's see it with our own eyes, whether or not the accusations of him stealing art are true. You're meeting Lady Anne and the others behind at the train station, right? What am I? I'm adding words. Like, it's not even there, and I'm just throwing words into my speech bubbles. What? Why?
Come on.
Phantom thieves going by train. This ain't any different from how I get home from school, you know. The train is the fastest way to go. Plus, we can bring pets on here. What? Oh, Morgana. Right.
No!
Hey, who you calling a pet? I am a dignified person, dammit. Dude, be quiet. We didn't pay the pet fare, so it doesn't matter. If we're not going to pay the pet fare, why take the train anyway? I'm the one guiding you to your destination. You should be calling me master.
Hey!
Ooh, kitty! Oh, no. Shoot. Is that your pet, mister? I heard it meowing. It's just a creature. It's just something. I don't know what's gonna piss Morgana off more. Oh god, it's just a creature. What's a creature? Isn't that a kitty? It's a toy. It meows when you press on its head.
Hey,
you heard her, musical. Press on its head. This is ridiculous. Do it again. Time to put. Oh god, I'm choking. Oh shit, took off my glasses. Oh god. Oh, I did not know how much I needed this laugh. Time to button mash on the guy's head. I think we broke it. It's so funny, I want to hear it again. I just threw up in my mouth. Seriously? The next stop is Shibuya. Shibuya, doors will open up the left side. Oh, thank God. This crazy train ride's over. And this is our stop. We'll see you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Oh, God. That is animal abuse right there. And I loved every second of it.
Yeah.
So which line do we got to transfer to? Doesn't look like there are any stations close by that address. Oh my god. Ah, get it together, gamer. God damn it. Woohoo. Whew. Okay, I'm good.
For real?
What? Then we gotta walk the rest of the way? What kind of phantom thief takes a train and then walks to their destination? These phantom thieves. Stop your complaining. I just had my neck snapped. It's supposedly a shack, but this is the neighborhood he lives in. As expected of a famous artist.
Okay, let's
looks like
get
the
going.
Fastest route is to get to the station square and then go to Central Street. Let's move. All right. Sounds good to me. Where are we? Oh, we're over here. Ew. Okay. Hold on. There's a bread shop. Yeah, want to grab some food? Oh, god damn it. You two schmucks. Don't get in the way of my food. Could a gentleman like that really be plagiarizing and abusing his pupils? Yeah, I was about to say, then he's probably one of the victims. Alright, come on, you two. Let's boogie. Let's get out of here. Oh my god, I love this game so much. That's just absolutely hilarious.
Wait.
It's supposed to be in a residential area past Central Street. Yeah, so I have to walk a bit. All right, that's fine with me. Oh!
Suguru Kamoshida, former Olympian, teacher at Shujin Academy.
It's the old guy again. He's the SIU director. What does that stand for?
Reason for turning himself in is a heavy conscience, huh? Human mind doesn't change that easily, let alone their natural temperament. Shujin Academy. Seems doubtful. Perhaps I'll have someone look into it. Just in case.
What are you... Are you seriously suspicious of us already? I mean, that someone is doing it? Like,
is
forcing people to change?
Is that it?
Are you kidding me? Seriously! How horrible of phantom thieves are we if this is such an easy thing to spot?
We're at the right address.
Well, I guess he wasn't lying about the shack part.
The door plate does say Madarame.
You ring the bell.
Me? The walls won't collapse when I do, will they? No one sneeze or we'll blow this house down, okay?
Hey, be quiet or I'll button mash again.
Who that? Sensei is currently...
It's Takamaki.
I'll be right out.
Gee, don't be too eager.
People really do live here.
Takamaki-san.
You two are here as well?
Hey, what's with the cold reception, dude?
Hey.
What up?
Sorry, but we ain't here to talk about the modeling thing. There's something we gotta ask you. Is it true Madarame's plagiarizing stuff? He's abusing people too, yeah?
Are you serious?
We read about it online.
This?
Did we break him too?
Preposterous! Not only is the plagiarism impossible, but abuse? If he hated children so much to harm them, he would never allow pupils into his home. And I'm the one residing here and studying under him. I'm saying it's not true, so it's beyond doubt.
Or you could be lying to cover him. Or you're just afraid to admit it.
You might be lying about it.
Yeah.
That is utter rubbish.
Oh, he broke. For just a quick second, did you see that? He stuttered.
I had no family when Sensei took me in and raised me into what you see now. If you continue to ridicule the man I owe my life to, you will rue this day.
Jeez.
You really think that?
Intense much?
Yusuke.
Uh-oh.
What's the matter? I heard you yelling.
These people are slandering you with baseless rumors.
Forgive them, Yusuke. They must have heard some bad rumors and came in worry for their friend's safety.
Understood, Sensei.
Well, even I doubt that a cranky old man like myself could be liked by everyone.
That's not what we meant.
I'm sorry to have butt in on your conversation.
Are you? Are you really sorry?
However, I do have neighbors around. Won't you please keep it down? Now, if you'll excuse me.
There's still something off about that guy.
That was discourteous of me. I'm sorry. I know. I think you'll be able to believe in Sensei if you saw that painting.
Painting? What painting?
It's his maiden work, as well as his most representative piece. It's titled Sayuri.
Sayuri?
This was the painting that inspired me to become an artist.
It's so beautiful.
I don't know all this fine art stuff, but even I can tell that this is impressive.
When I first saw you, I felt the same powerful emotion as when I saw this painting.
Me?
I wish to pursue beauty like this.
So is that why you asked her to model?
And I believe drawing you will be part of that pursuit. I implore you, seriously consider my offer. I'm sorry that you took the time to come all this way, but I must assist Sensei today. I hope that we can discuss this further another time. If you'll excuse me then.
Alright, I guess we'll let you go for now.
Those two seem like nice guys, don't they?
They do, but there's something wrong about all this. It seems too convenient.
Maybe the Madarame we heard about in Mementos is a different person.
Man, right when we thought we found a new target, too.
How's the Metanav?
Oh yeah, let's check this.
Hey, the app.
Was it picking up our conversation? This display. It means that Madarame has a palace too, right?
I knew it.
But why?
Madarame, plagiarism, and then Shaq, huh? These seem to be the keywords.
For real though, what the hell's going on? Does an old man like him really have a palace?
We have the person's name and the location.
The proof is in the pudding, Ryuji. It's here.
All that's left is the what that Madarame mistakes the shack for to enter his palace.
You mean, like how Kamoshida thought the school was his castle?
That's right. Let's try saying some things. They can be random guesses.
So, what is it that so basically, what is his distortion? So, Madarame is the who, the plagiarism is the... is what he's doing. The shack is the where, but then what is it? What is his distortion? How does he see things?
It's a bit sudden, though.
Entitlement?
Why don't we start with castle?
No, I doubt it's that. It's not going to be that simple. No candidates.
Then what about prison?
No candidates found.
Ah, what a pain. Jail, warehouse, and guidance counseling office. Might as well add farm.
No candidates found.
Ryuji.
Not a single hit.
Should we come back another time? A building that's related to artists. If we think from there, what would it be?
A gallery? A museum? An art school? Art supply store? A museum. That kind of means the same thing as gallery in this context, right? I'm gonna try that. Oh, shit!
Beginning navigation? Whoa, really?
That was it? Oh, wow, okay. Holy crap, okay, that does it then. So, a museum. So his palace is based after a museum.
Hey, wait!
Hey, when did you activate the nav? You surprised me. Didn't have much of a choice. I think we just happened to get it right. So maybe he views everything as belonging to him. Like his own personal museum or something like that. Probably would have figured it out once you started walking on two legs. Yeah.
Hey.
So even you can slip into the metaverse without realizing it, Morgana. Yup. In a place with minimal cognitive distortion, the differences can be subtle.
What?
Forget that. Look. Yeah, look at this place. Holy crap. That shack is seriously some kind of museum?
Hey.
Let's go check it out. Sounds like a plan. We're all the way over here. Might as well start. Oh god, look at all the people.
So extravagant. To the point that it's gaudy. It's a museum, right?
This is Matarame's?
A palace is a scenery driven by desires. Just like how Kamoshida's palace was a castle.
Matarame's artwork is on display at museums in reality too, though. His exhibit was popular, and people already respect him. Why would he fantasize about a museum?
You got a point. It ain't related to plagiarism or abuse either.
Unless he thinks... Oh god, unless he has a really twisted idea of what his artwork means or something.
Let's try looking around. Racking our brains here won't do us any good.
Right.
Yeah, I guess so.
Aside, ain't a museum a must for Phantom Thieves?
Well, I guess if you think of it in that way, we're about to rob a museum. That seems kind of appropriate for our profession. Yeah, there are probably traps, too.
Yeah, all those old man's fans were super strong and all.
That has nothing to do with this.
But man, just look at that insane crowd.
Well then, it's time we begin our infiltration. No, we're not gonna wait in the line, Ryuji. Don't be stupid, we're not going to the front door. But there's a high wall around that building. We'll just have to find our way up and over it then. In any case, let's get going. Sweet, alright. So, how the hell did we do that? The truck maybe? Yeah, it looks like it. I'm curious though, what's up with the line? Can these guys not see us? Don't get too close to them. They're probably just distracted by their thoughts of the great painter. Come on, let's go. Ah, okay. Fair enough. Wait, look at that. I can see like a guard over there. That's a shadow.
Yep.
This really is how he thinks of that rundown shack. It's overwhelmingly shiny. Don't you like the shiny, Morgana? It's just not hitting me that this is that old guy's palace. That's why we're here, right? Come on, let's go check it out. All right, we're in. Where's that dude? What? Oh god. We return. Hey, send more guards over here. Just the two of us will be able to deal with this whole crowd.
Oh.
This is our chance. It looks like security is focused on the front entrance. That means there'll be less of them elsewhere. Let's go. Ah, okay, so I can't go that way. I'm gonna have to go through a garden? Wow, this music's super chill. I like it. It's very zen. I feel like I'm breaking into some high-class ritzy place. How about it? Can I jump on you? I cannot. Alright. Fair enough. Can I? What? How the hell? Game. Oh, go this way. Doy. Alright, fair enough. Ah, open skylight. That's our way in? I think so.
Hey!
Ooh, the skylight's open. I think we can get in here. But it's a pretty far drop. Will we be able to get back out this way? Don't worry. I have a rope. I'm our tool specialist, after all. Are you? I thought that was me. I thought I was the one making the tools. So what's your call, Joker? Wanna head inside? Hey, let's do this. Might as well. No time like the present. Breaking into an art museum, I like it. And we're in.
How suspicious.
It's quiet. Almost too quiet. Hey, this... it's moving. Come on, we're in a palace. That ain't anything to be freaking out over. The palace reflects its ruler's heart. We may want to check these paintings out. Really? Okay. Distorted painting. Oh, hey, there's some kind of explanation here. It's someone's name and age? What the hell? That can't be the title of the painting, right? Do you think it's the artist's name? Oh, no. Oh, God, please don't tell me that what he puts on display are his students in his name. Oh, God. Let's check the other paintings, too. I think there might be something important about them. Yeah, I think Morgana's caught on already. I will admit this. Morgana's a very, very... it's the art piece. is a very quick study. He's a very quick cat. Let's go in the next room. Okay. What is this? It looks like a security alarm. I'm not gonna try it. Oh, we can't get through there. I guess I'm gonna have to go through this. But they didn't go off. Let me examine. Yeah, another. It's got the name and age on the plaque. This one has a full name. Oh. Okay. Can't do anything there yet. Hello. Oh, yoink! Crappy portrait. This one has a name too. Is this painting the same deal? Same deal as all the rest? Oh, it's starting to look like it. I don't like these little boxes. I feel like I'm gonna trip an alarm or something. Staring at us. Okay, clearly there's like one I should be finding.
Focus.
A bad sculpture. A plastic frame.
Feel it.
Give me all the things.
I can feel it.
Oh, hello.
Hey.
Hey, this doesn't make any sense. Madarami's famous for having a variety of art styles. But all the portraits on display here look the same. This is way different from what was at the... Wait a sec!
Damn it.
Ain't that the guy we saw in Mementos? You know, the one who was shit-talking Madarami. Yeah, that's him. Natsuhiko Nakanohara. His name's written on the plaque. Why does it look like he's covered in blood? Dude, I don't get it. Why is there a painting of him in here? More important, why is his name written underneath it? You're right. Doesn't art usually have, like, the title of the piece or the artist's name? This is quite the mystery. Alright, let's keep looking around. It looks like he's covered in blood. Yeah, seriously. Oh, just fans. Ooh, hello! Damn it! Somewhere. Nothing in there. An unsigned mug. I was about to say that looked very familiar. Hi, Yusuke.
Hey.
Isn't this a painting of that guy? It says Yusuke Kitagawa. There's no mistaking it.
Huh?
Wait a second. What do you think these paintings are? I think these are his pupils. Well painted. No. Yeah, these are definitely all of his pupils.
What?
For real? All of them? But it was only Yusuke when we went to his place before. This must include former pupils as well. Only one remains now. Taking into account what that Nakanohara guy said earlier, things are getting clearer. All right, let's keep investigating. We need something to further confirm our deductions. I agree. What's going on? Oh, thanks. Loading screen. Random loading screen. Button?
Wait!
Damn it! It's probably gonna open the door.
I can feel it.
You won't even let me do it.
I can see it.
Damn it, game. Hello? This is the entrance to the museum, I think. A pamphlet.
Hmm?
What's up? You find something? Yeah, let's check it out. What? Oh, hello. I'll take that. A protect mask. Nice. What the hell does this do? It evades curse. Low chance. All right. Interesting. I don't think it's any better than what I already have. There's another
Look,
one over here.
A treasure chest. Oh.
And it's locked, but we do have a lockpick. Haha. I've come prepared. Training whip, pearl and snuff soul. That's a weapon for Anne. A training whip? Oh god. Why the hell is something like that in here? A whip used for training. Oh boy. Four more attack, two less accuracy, but that's fine. I'll give it to her. Okay, let's grab one of these pamphlets then. Detailed, yeah. This place is super detailed. Honestly, I think it's even more detailed than Kamoshida's palace. And it's a map. It may even show us the location of his treasure.
Nice.
That is a possibility. At the very least, it should be a good reference for the scale of this place. Huh? But the map only shows half the museum. I see. It says it's 1 out of 2. Then there, the 2 out of 2's gotta be around here somewhere, right? Just how big is this place? We can worry about that another time. Right now, our objective is looking into Madarami's cognition. We may have to reconsider our plan depending on what we find. I mean, he's got a palace. Seems pretty fishy to me. I agree. And no, the other pamphlet is not there. So we can't even go past this way. Hello, giant sculpture. Oh god, what's with the people in the sculpture?
Look at this. The Infinite Spring? A conglomerate work of art that the great director Madarame created with his own funds.
Huh?
These individuals must offer their ideas to the director for the rest of their lives.
Whoa, wait, what?
Those who cannot do so have no worth living? Hey, this is most likely about the plagiarism, right?
What? It sounds like
it. What a phony geezer.
In other words, his pupils are his property. He doesn't even qualify as an artist if this is true.
That's what I was afraid of. That's why there's paintings of all his pupils, because he owns them. They're his work.
He's stealing the ideas from talented students in exchange for securing their livelihood. I wondered about those portraits on display. They must all be his pupils through his cognition, as even says that they have no worth. Couldn't this be about the abuse? Madarame will keep them around as long as they're useful to him. But the moment they're not...
He's treating them like slaves or tools!
Oh, great, not again.
Why is Yusuke keeping quiet about this? He's got no reason to cover this up.
I mean, unless he's new, he hasn't exactly been brought into this yet. I don't know. I don't know what his deal is.
He did say that he owes Madarame his life for being taken in.
Oh, there is that. He might feel a degree of debt, so he probably won't complain.
But still.
When we were at the exhibit, I praised one of the pieces on display. But Kitagawa-kun acted strange.
I bet any amount of money he's the one who drew that.
Maybe that piece was plagiarized too.
What's the call? Ain't this enough to target Madarame?
Well, what do you all think? I'm thinking this is a surefire thing, but I don't want to hear you guys' opinions.
We should confirm these facts with Yusuke first.
Yeah.
Confirm what, though?
It means we should get solid evidence that such crimes actually took place.
What a pain in the ass.
You're ready to just, you know, run off half-cocked there, Ryuji. We need hard
Besides,
evidence.
There's too much we don't know about Madarame yet.
You're right. I'll try contacting Kitagawa-kun. I might be able to get the truth out of him if I accept his modeling offer.
This is true. We have an inside agent. Ooh, wait, this is really cool. I'm getting excited.
Wait, you're gonna do that?
Well, what
you
better way?
Better come with me, okay? I'm scared to go alone.
Famous renowned artist, huh? Wow, this might be tougher than Kamoshida.
Yeah, Kamoshida was famous, you know, locally, inside the school, and with the administration. This guy is, like, nationally known. This is gonna be tricky. I can already see it.
Well, we'll just prep ourselves until we get confirmation from Yusuke.
This is our first mission as real Phantom Thieves. We're gonna succeed no matter what.
Hmm. Well, we're all excited. I'll give us that. The reason why Yusuke is hiding the truth, huh? Oh, hello. Would you really forgive someone unconditionally if you owe your life to them? I'm not so sure anymore. What are you bringing this up for? According to Kitagawa-kun, Madarame isn't a problem. What do you mean, he's not a problem? Something wrong? I mean, I know Madarame is a bad person, but still, maybe I'm so hesitant because I haven't actually met any of his victims. Yeah, I guess that part's totally different from what happened with Kamoshida. Yeah, we could see what Kamoshida was doing, because he was doing it to us, too. So we had no problems targeting him. We knew 100% what a bag of shit that guy was. And we wanted to do something about this. We don't know this guy from Adam. That's actually a very interesting way to look at it. This might be an extreme line of thinking, but if an evil person isn't causing any trouble now, is there really a point in us stepping in? Ooh, she has a point, yeah. Oh, this is so cool. They're actually talking about the ethics of this. Huh. I didn't think the game would go into that. So we're going to let Yusuke decide if Madarame's worth going after or not. I don't know. If it were me, I'd never forgive that bastard. Yeah, but that's you. You're not the one who's in the situation. Yeah, let's see how he feels. That's the best thing we can do. Yeah, I guess we could talk some more after that. Okay, let's meet in Shibuya after school tomorrow. This is like one of those situations where, like, what is the scenario they say? If you could go back in time and kill Hitler, would you?
Okay.
One of those things? Like, when he was an art student? Oh, wow, that's topical. When he was an art student in college, would you go back and kill him? Would you go back in time and kill him right after he was born? Because you knew the things he would do. Actually, can I do stuff? No. Of course not. Of course not! Freaking, I'll clock you, game, I swear. I'll clock the game. But yeah, would you go back in time and kill him as a baby? Because you knew the evil things he'd do when he would grow up. But by doing that, you will irreversibly create a butterfly effect that will, you know, change absolutely everything about the course of human history from that point forward. And could you let yourself do it? Also, another thought exercise was, like, would you go and save the Titanic and make sure people didn't die on it? Now, that's like, you save people's lives, but think about the implications that could have on how history played out. You know, people could not be born. People could, different people could have died in situations. You never know. Are we just a bunch of thugs? You know what? Probably. Yeah, I knew it too. He does not like us. At least you and me. He likes Anne. The two of us?
No. Not one bit.
I'm gonna make him pay.
Ain't like he thinks it is. Pisses me off just thinking about it. But that's just interesting. Like, I love thought exercise, stuff like that. Shitty adults do whatever they want. Makes me sick. I'm not wrong, am I? Well, don't worry. We'll take him down. Don't tell Anne I called you, by the way. Seriously. See you tomorrow. Yeah, we'll take down all of these crappy people in one way or the other. But we do need to check. We need to make sure that what we're doing isn't, you know, too preemptive. Oh, hello. You rang? All right, I contacted Kitagawa-kun about modeling for him. Still waiting for his response. Thanks. I really have no idea what I'm supposed to do as an art model, though. Cover yourself in paint? Can you at least try to take this seriously? What? I'm just having fun! Look, you don't gotta go all out for this. You're only doing it so you can get dirt on Madarame, remember? Well, that is true. It sounded like Kitagawa-kun wants this to be a private picture of his, though. Oh god, really? If you pose in the nude, I will clock him. I swear. Well, I guess I'll let you guys know when he contacts me again. Yep, sure. Like, come on, dude. That's not right. You just met this girl. You don't know her.
Hey!
I got a response. He said he wants me to come over after school today. Perfect. He probably changed his plans immediately just so he could get you over there. We need to find out from Kitagawa-kun if what we saw in the palace was true. Hey, quiet down. It's that student council president. Uh-oh. Makoto? Jesus. Oh, she's over there. She's talking to Mishima? Oh, no. I knew he'd be a liability. She got hold of Mishima today. It'd suck if she noticed us. Come on, let's split up. Okay, see you later. Wonderful. Oh, boy.
All right.
Finally landed a big target. Come on, let's get some dirt on Madarame. But man, Anne's late.
Sorry.
Oh, here she is. I was thinking about some things and didn't notice how much time had passed. Thinking about what?
Hey.
Don't you think Kitagawa-kun has to be protecting Madarame? I mean, they live together, so he'd have to be aware of Madarame's true nature. The only reason I can think for him doing that is that Madarame has something on him. Yeah, that is weird.
Wait.
But that's why we're going to check it out, right? You really want to be you ready to be a model? Yeah, I'm prepared. What do you mean prepared? Prepared for what?
Hey.
Something seemed different about her to you? Did she cut her bangs?
Whoa.
Ooh, nice eye. I didn't cut them. Huh. Well, let's get going. We gotta talk to Yusuke. Kitagawa-kun seemed really happy when I agreed to be his model.
Okay,
once he finishes drawing and gets a little friendlier, we should bring up Madarame. Alright, sure. Why not?
I thought it would just be you coming, Takamaki-san.
Wouldn't you get nervous too, if it was just the two of us?
We're here to keep an eye on you, so don't try anything perverted, okay?
Stop making such odd assumptions. I have absolutely no interest in her as someone of the opposite sex.
Oh god, please. Please don't tell me you're like Kanji 2.0.
Huh?
Is there a problem?
No, not really.
Oh, Anne, did you get your hopes up?
Well then, let's get started.
Kitagawa-kun?
Oh, he's focusing. He's focusing, all right.
Sure?
It's no use.
He's in his own world. Well, I guess we're gonna have to wait till he's done anyway.
This isn't what we planned. We were gonna catch him off guard and make him spill his beans, weren't we?
How are we supposed to know this was gonna happen? Guess we just gotta wait till he's done. What an effing pain in the ass.
Perhaps I should try going outside this room.
Ooh. I don't know. You are just a cat, at least in this form. There's no way anybody would be, like, suspicious unless there's something serious. I don't know. That sounds a little risky, but I think you'd be the best person to go looking around. Don't get caught.
Who do you think you're talking to?
I think I'm talking to someone who got caught by Kamoshida trying to frickin' steal his crown. Don't get caught, or I'll frickin' button mash.
This is too boring, so I'm going to scout around a bit.
Alright, go for it. It's weird how flashy that door is. And is that a lock? A door with a hefty lock. What could be in there? Are you gonna find a way in?
Are you done?
It's no good.
Huh? What do you mean?
What?
I'm sorry. Am I the problem?
No, not at all. It's just... I'm having trouble staying focused today. I'm sorry, but we'll have to resume this another time.
Oh, hell no! How many hours do you think you made us wait?
I'm sorry. We had another reason for seeing you today. We needed to talk to you.
It's about those rumors regarding your sensei.
Yeah, we're getting straight into it, aren't we?
This again.
That painting I saw at the exhibit. You're the one who actually painted it, right?
That's...
I knew it.
Yeah, I had a feeling too.
Your sensei's seriously messed up. He just thinks of his pupils as tools. That's why he doesn't give a damn whether he steals their work or physically beats them. I'll make this clear. There's no point in hiding stuff from us.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
You couldn't go against him, could you? I'm sure we can help you out, though.
Stop it. It's just as you all say. We're our sensei's artwork.
That's
Don't
twisted.
Don't misunderstand me, though.
That's really screwed up.
I offered my ideas to him myself. As such, it can't be called plagiarism. Sensei is simply suffering from artist's block right now.
Dude, still.
But does he actually beat you? Like, physically? Because we could
he
pin him on that.
Soon.
Then why are you sticking around? All his other pupils ran away. Aren't you the only one left?
What's wrong with a pupil helping out his master? There are no victims here. Stop pushing your self-centered righteousness on me.
You're really okay with this?
I'm supporting Sensei as his pupil. Where's the wrong in that? Don't ever come here again. If you do, I'll sue you for causing a disturbance.
Okay, hold on. You can't do that. That is not a possibility.
Hold it!
Is it?
We're not done talking here!
Then you leave me with no choice.
Hey!
What are you doing?
I'm reporting you to the police.
What the fuck?!
I asked Hakamaki-san to be my model today, but I don't recall ever calling you two here.
What the F, man?
Ryuji, stop it! Calm down, okay?
Damn it!
I won't report you, but only under one condition.
Oh no.
Never come back here again!
Right?
What's that?
I want you to continue being my model, Hakamaki-san.
But you said that it wasn't working out today.
That's because I was unconsciously being modest for your sake. However, I have nothing to worry about anymore. If you are willing to bear everything to me...
Okay, hold the phone here. This is getting really risque.
I will put my heart and soul into creating the best nude painting ever.
That's it! You're getting clocked. Bend over. I'm gonna clock you in the face. And then in the ass, with my foot.
What?
Nude?
To think I'd be able to create a nude painting with my most ideal model. Of course, you two won't be allowed in, and I ask that you forget about our discussion today as well. If I don't submit a new piece to Sensei soon, there will be some inconveniences.
Oh, you son of a...
Nude? Meaning it'll be without any clothes, right? Why are things suddenly escalating like that?
Because those are my terms.
What the hell, man?
But that's... Wait, ain't that bad?
Sensei is out during the afternoon while the art exhibit is on, so I can use this place freely. I should buy more art supplies.
Will you give me a second here?
Of course. I'm willing to wait. I'll make time according to your plans, but please come before the exhibit ends.
No, that's not what I mean! Why are you not listening?
Sensei will be returning home soon. We're done for today. Takamaki-san, I'll be waiting for you to contact me.
Oh, dear lord.
No, no, no! We are not done talking here!
Hey, what should we do?
Oh, poor Anne. Oh, jeez. I don't know.
Yeah, damn it. He got us good this time.
Don't give up so easily!
Oh, god.
Is she done being a model?
Oh yeah, let's pick up the cat.
A cat?
You moron.
Crap. That's it. Time for your daily dose of button mashing, Morgana.
He's totally out of his mind! I'm gonna have to pose nude if this keeps up!
How dare that, Yusuke?
The way he said it, it's not gonna be semi, but full-on nude.
Full nudity? Lady Anne's gonna...
Drop it!
You know, you won't have to worry about that if we make Madarame confess before the exhibit ends.
It's true.
Kitagawa-kun thinks he owes his life to him. Is there a need to make Madarame confess?
Then, Lady Anne, you're fine with bearing it all?
I am not!
Madarame's no different from Kamoshida. That asshole's using Yusuke, who doesn't have parents. You're telling me we should just ignore how he's being treated horribly like the other pupils?
No. It is frustrating to leave this alone, even if Kitagawa-kun is fine with it himself.
You can't leave it be because you've endured a lot yourself with Kamoshida.
Hmm, that's true.
Yeah.
The only thing about this is, though, is that... Obviously, we could tell he's actually not fine with being treated like this by Madarame, but he keeps saying he is, and I don't know, because it is his choice. It's not like Madarame's got other pupils that he's, you know, beating the crap out of and stealing ideas from. It's just Yusuke, and Yusuke, despite having, you know, grievances about it, is willingly putting himself into the position. Do we, as a third party, have the right to change that? To decide ourselves that Yusuke is wrong in thinking that and completely change his circumstances. Now, I'm sure the game's going to make it so that, you know, ultimately we're not wrong about making this decision, but this is a very morally gray area. It's very interesting to kind of explore this.
Anyways, we got to go after this guy. Madarame is the kind of target we've been waiting for. Let's help Yusuke come to his senses too, before he ends up like us.
Right.
We need to look into Madarame first.
There might be tons more stuff that hasn't been exposed yet, too.
It may become easier for us to investigate his palace if he's preoccupied with his exhibit.
Also, there's the thing about me modeling. Kitagawa-kun said there'd be inconveniences unless he submits a new piece. Maybe that's going to be announced soon as Madarame's next work.
Does that mean the whole country's gonna see you nude?
Oh, God. Are you not confident? Oh, no! I can't see that. That's not the point!
What? Are you saying I'm... No, I mean, that's not what this is about!
We must deal with Madarame, no matter what, before his exhibit ends.
Let's start after school tomorrow. Oh, it'll be a pain if Miss President finds us on the rooftop again, so... where to meet up? Let's see... I guess that walkway-like place in Shibuya would work. It's near Madarame's place, too.
Changing our hideout periodically, huh? That's a plan I don't mind backing.
Okay, that's fair. Your hideout has moved from the Shujin Academy rooftop to the Shibuya Teikyu building accessway. Okay.
Hey, can I talk to you kids for a sec?
Oh, hello, Yuki. Wait. Wait a minute! That's not...
From the looks of things, you don't seem like the ordinary stalking fans.
That sounds like Yukiko. So that's obviously the same voice actress. You're... Who are you? What's your name?
Oh, sorry. I should have been more clear. I'm actually looking for people that know Madarame's pupils. There's this painting, Sayuri, that was supposedly stolen in the past. But there's this rumor that it was taken by one of his pupils in retaliation for being abused. Have you heard anything about that?
Ryuji knows.
Me? I don't know nothing.
I see. There's no case unless there's a victim, and if there's no proof of abuse, I can't write either. Looks like I'm back to square one. Sorry for taking your time.
It's okay.
I'm a journalist. If you ever get any leads, mind contacting me here? See you then.
Okay. Well, see you later. Whoever you are. No way. I heard the voice, I saw the black hair, and the face kind of looked like an older version of her, and my brain immediately went like, what? No, that can't be. No way. No way, no how. No way, no how. I feel dumb even thinking about it. Bad gamer, bad. Oh, man. Whatever, I still can't forgive him demanding to paint Lady On nude and then claiming to report us to the police. Oh, hello. Ring, ring, ring.
Hello?
Oh, it's Mishima. Hey, what's up?
Actually...
Someone who received a change of heart contacted me on the fan site. Said he wants to meet with you to discuss another person who needs a change of heart. We've only ever done that to one person. That was Naka Oblaka. I can't remember his name. Naka Nohara. You're better off talking to him in person if you want specifics. His target is a terrible person. Okay. I'll have him wait for you at Shibuya Station. Yep, Naka Nohara. That's Madarame's student.
See you.
Yeah, good luck. Thanks, dude. Alright, so that is... What the hell? I am super popular tonight. Found something insane about Madarame. Sounds like a student of his offed himself when he couldn't speak up about Madarame stealing his work. Oh god, is that true? A journalist was looking into Madarame too. It could be real. Someone died though. No one's talking about it. I bet it was covered up. I wonder if Kitagawa-kun has heard anything. It'd be great if he could help us out. Ain't that asking a bit much? After today, he's probably gonna be on edge about us. Oh, anyway, Madarame's still a piece of crap. Let's meet up tomorrow. It'll be our first time at the new hideout. It's that passageway in Shibuya, right? Got it. See you guys tomorrow. If the rumor Ryuji just spoke of is true, there have to be other victims. Yeah, that's for sure.
Well then.
It's our first job as Phantom Thieves. And of course, we don't get to do anything at night. No. Because why would we ever want to do something at night? I don't know. I hate you, game. I hate you. Thanks all for watching. If you enjoyed the series, please be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Also, be sure to check me out on Twitter at MusicalGamer11. And last but certainly not least, check me out on Patreon. Becoming a patron today will get you wonderful, glorious perks and interesting things, as well as being able to support me and the channel. And it allows me to make more content for you guys in the future. So think about it. All right, that is all. This is the Musical Gamer signing off. I will see you guys in the next video. Catch you guys next time.